Shalom. First of all, I'd like to start off by giving all glory and honor to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahshai, Bashem, Rakakadash, double honor to teacher, sellers, and apostle of great millstone, also to likewise brothers who are putting out the truth, faithfully, fearlessly feeding the sheep unto you, brothers and sisters, tuning in. Shalom. And as you can see here in this video here, what I have on the screen here is called Dream of Reparation Hits Political Reality in California. Now, this is... This happened recently here, and as you can see here, this Jake, okay, we're gonna refer to him as Esau's coon, okay, because I mean, these men, okay, in Yashra, Israel, so-called Black Native Americans, Latino, really just don't get it, okay. So let's read the article here. This is it says Sacramento, California, California Democrats 3 years ago set out to confront more than a century of discrimination towards Black residents with a push for reparations. Now, those ambitions have faded and frustrations mounting in their own ranks. Now, why are they frustrated? Let's go into the book of Isaiah 31 and 1. It says, woe to them that go down to Egypt for help and stay on horses and trust in chariots because they are many and in horsemen because they are very strong. But they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, because the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahshai is the comforter, okay, of our people, okay? He's the comforter. Okay, of the tribe of Israel, okay, our so-called Blacks and Americans, Latino, not Esau. And you have these coons, what you see here, okay, and you can see that these people are like literally laughing at him. I mean, when you take a look at this guy and how he's walking and strutting with that stupid grin on his face, this bald head, bald-faced, doggone coon Negro, okay, who bowing on to Esau because he's looking for a quick way, you know, to get rich, you know, and trying to find some type of loophole, which there isn't. Okay, it reminds you of this scene here. Take a look at this. This is this guy here from I'm Gonna Get You, Sucker.
People primping, pimping, sharp as razor blades.
Yo, check out homeboy. See, how many brothers out there, huh?
Look at the fish in his shoes.
Girl, he must be a rock star.
So as you saw inside there like that, everybody started laughing at that fool, man, because this what we have here is a fool. This is the book of Isaiah 31 and verse 2. And it says, yet he also is wise and will bring evil and will not call back his word, but will arise against the house of the evildoers and against the help of them that work iniquity. So this man is working iniquity because instead of seeking the Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahshai and putting his trust and hope in a Malak, Yahushua, Mashiach, who's going to come and take down Esau. Okay, he's seeking, okay, you know, that kind of get quick rich scheme here, you know, kind of similar to Al Shaft and the rest of them, you know, Esau, you owe us money and all that stuff. No, Esau doesn't owe us. The so-called white man does not owe anybody any money, okay? He was given the sword to do exactly what he did, which is what pillage, murder, rape, okay, and lie and steal. That's exactly what his job was to do, okay? And pursuing the Deuteronomy 28, okay, we're punished under this man for all our iniquities, okay? Let's continue on here. It says, despite his reputation as a liberal bastion, the Democratic supermajority that controls California legislature has recently squashed the kinds of criminal justice reform proposal that are central to the reparation movement, including bills that would have required police officers to obtain a warrant before searching the vehicle and ban police canines from biting suspect, which is nothing new, which, okay, they did back in what? The 60s when you had the so-called civil rights movement. Now, as you can see here on the left side here, you can see there's, what, 904 thumbs up and 4,000 thumbs down. Now, when you take a look at some of these comments, take a look at them. More Irish people were sent to U.S. and Africa and were treated just as bad. Where's the Irish money? Okay, and that's a good question. Where's the Irish money? Okay, because we know us being previous rulers over there, okay, that some of the people that look like Edomites, you know, who would call themselves Irish, okay, are also what? From the tribe of Israel, okay? And you look here, you see a lot of the comments that's coming here because, of course, this is never going to pass because why? The Lord is not going to allow this to pass, okay? He's not going to allow Jake to get off that easy. I just read, okay, exactly what, okay, the Lord is going to do. When we go into the book of Isaiah, this is the book of Isaiah, chapter 3. And one, and here's what really is going to come here. So for this Jake here who think that, you know, he was going to somehow lead and be given the Nobel Peace Prize or some crap, Here's what really is going to take place. This is Isaiah 3:1. It says, "For behold, the Lord of hosts, Yahweh Shemashiach, doth take away from Jerusalem and from Judah the stay and the staff, the whole stay of bread and the whole stay of water, the mighty man and the man of war, the judge, and the prophet, and the prudent, and the ancient, the captain of 50, and the honorable man," which this man will be considered an honorable man, okay? And it says, "and the counselor, and the cunning anticipator, and the eloquent orator," okay? So what is really coming? Jacob's trouble, okay? Jacob's trouble. These coons in high places, you cannot, okay, bargain or reason, okay, with the damn devil, which is Esau, the so-called white man, okay, because he was set up to do exactly, okay, what he's doing on earth, which is what? To bring about the destruction, okay, to get people out of their comfort zone, okay, especially the tribe of Israel, okay, and also what? Prepare to go up against Yahushua Mashiach, okay? The true reparation is coming, okay? We, okay, are the one that's letting these people know, okay? This man is not, okay, a representation of Israel, Yahshua, the so-called Black, Native Americans, and Latino. He's a representation of himself, the two-thirds, okay, which is a totally different tribe or different set of people, okay, within the tribe of Israel, okay? So the Lord has an elect, the one-third, and then there's these, okay, these undesirables, two-thirds, and this man is one of the leaders for those because they seek, okay, reparation from in the form of easy, quick money from our oppressor, Esau, the so-called white man. But here's what we go on the highway and the byway and speak about. This is the book of Isaiah 66, verse 13. It says, "And as one whom his mother comforted, so will I comfort you, and ye shall be comforted in Jerusalem." Yahushua Mashiach is comforting us, okay? He has the prophets comforting us. He has the brothers comforting each other. And he says, "And when you see this, your heart shall rejoice, and your bones shall flourish like an herb, and the hands of the Lord Yahweh Shemashiach shall be known towards his servants, and his indignation towards his enemy." Who's his enemies? Okay, starting with the so-called white man, the Esau, the Edomite, okay, and these other 16 nations that took crafty counsel against the children of the Most High, Yahweh Shemashiach, or so-called Blacks, Native Americans, and Latinos, all across this earth. And it says, "For behold, the Lord will come with fire, and with his chariots like a whirlwind, to rend his anger with fury, and his rebuke with flames of fire. For by fire and by sword will the Lord Yahweh Shemashiach plead with all flesh, and the slain of the Lord Yahweh Shemashiach shall be many." Okay? So there it is right there. That's part of the reparation that we brings out because this is what the Lord Yahweh Shemashiach, okay, has put us out there to do. We can further, okay, go into the book of Ezekiel 35, okay, and start with verse 1. It says, "Moreover, the word of the Lord Yahweh Shemashiach came unto me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against Mount Seir and prophesy against it," which we know Mount Seir, okay, is the current day, you know, Great Babylon, America, okay? Goes on all the different names, you know, Idumea, okay, Bozra, okay? And it says, "And say unto it, thus said the Lord, power of God, behold, O Mount Seir, I am against thee, and I will stretch out my hand against thee, and I will make thee most desolate." So there's your damn reparation. We are out there speaking the reparation, true reparation, of what is going to take place. Not this man right here, okay? He doesn't represent, okay, the righteous of Yahshua, a so-called Black, Native American, Latino, the man who cry and sigh against the abomination of this place, the wicked, okay, who rule, okay, without mercy, oppressing us day in, day out, okay? And it says, "And I will lay thy cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am the Lord, Yahweh Shemashiach, because thou hast had a perpetual hatred, and has shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity, in the time that their iniquity had an end." So why would this doggone dumb grinning coon, with these people laughing at his ass, his stupid ass, okay, look at them, they're laughing at him. Why would he think that people that absolutely hate him, who has shed his blood, okay, it's going to just give you suitcases of money, okay, something like what they would ask for, $5 million, and just asshole, this doggone idiot, really believed that was going to take place, okay? And it says, "Therefore, as I live, said the Lord, power of God, I will prepare thee unto blood." There's your damn reparation there, Esau. See, you're going to be getting your reparation. Your reparation is by blood, okay? You have to pay with your blood, not some paper, okay? And blood shall pursue thee, meaning you cannot escape. It's judgment, it's blood, that's bloodshed. There's great bloodshed that is going to be coming here on Great Babylon, America. said, thou hast not hated blood, even blood shall pursue thee. And so that's a true reparation right there. The Lord is coming back, okay, with Dagon and Bozrah, okay? And he is going to recompense Esau. So for those of you out there that think that guys like this are going to somehow convince these crackers, okay, to give you money and do what? Well, you see what the opinion, okay, of the people think, okay? What do you think is going to happen? Everybody believe that they should be, that they have been oppressed here in Great Babylon, America, okay? But that's not the case. The Lord said that he's going to deal with Esau on a personal level, and it's going to be by his damn blood. Billions of these Babylon crackers, okay, must pay with their blood, and that is true reparation. Lord willing, you are edified. I'd like to close it by giving all glory and honor to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Rakakadash. Double honors and teachers, elders, and apostles of Great Millstone, and to likewise, brothers, pushing out this truth, faithfully, fearlessly, feeding the sheep, and to brothers and sisters tuning in, Shalom.